Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to correctly remove the background from any logo. After that, you will learn how to convert any pixelated logo to a pure vector using Photoshop. At the end of the tutorial, you'll get a free action to convert any low-resolution logo or shape to a full vector with a couple of clicks. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Remove the background. Let's start with this logo. Since our logo here is a single color logo, the best option here will be the color range. Just go to Select and choose Color Range. Color Range allows you to select all similar color pixels within your image. We will use it to select the background color to be able to remove it. Just choose sample colors from this drop-down menu. And with the eyedropper tool, pick the background color like that. Increase the fuzziness all the way to 200 and uncheck invert all the time. Click OK. Then click on this little mask icon. Now select the mask itself and press Ctrl and I to invert the selection. This will invert the mask and make the background hidden and the logo visible. And this is our final isolated result. But if we put our isolated logo on any dark background like that, we will see that fringe on the edges like that. And to remove that, just click the Layers Mask and choose Select and Mask. Change the view to On Black and increase opacity to 100% to be able to see the fringe. Now increase the feather to a value below 0.5%. Increase the contrast and decrease the shift edge until the fringe disappears. You can now check the Decontaminate Colors option with 100% amount to make sure that the fringe has completely disappeared. And change the output to New Layer with Layer Mask, then click OK. This is our logo without any fringe. And here is the before. Just delete both the old layer and the color layer. Then you can export your isolated logo as a PNG file from here. Let's take another example. If you have a colorful logo and it has the same color in the background, color range will not work in that case. This will remove any pixel with any similar color like that. In that case, we should use another selection method. For example, the Magic Wand tool will do a great job right here. Just select it and increase tolerance to any acceptable value above 30. Now click on the background to select it. And also you can hold the Shift key and click to add any non-selected areas to your selection. Now click on the mask icon. Then select the mask and click Ctrl and I to invert your selection. And that's how to remove the background correctly using the color range and the Magic Wand tool. Step 2. Vectorize a single color logo or shape. I want to convert this low quality logo to a fully editable vector that can be edited using any vector software. If I zoom in, you may see how low quality it is. To vectorize this logo, let's start by increasing the image size first. Change any dimension to around 2000 pixels, then click OK. Zoom out with Ctrl and 0. Now go to Select and choose Color Range. Pick the logo color with the eyedropper tool. Then increase fuzziness all the way to 200. And make sure that Invert is unchecked. Then click OK. Now our logo is selected. Select any selection tool like that. Then right-click inside your selection and choose Make Work Path. Change tolerance to 1 or 2. Then click OK. Your selection will be converted to a work path like that. Without clicking anywhere, just go and create a color fill layer. Pick any color you want, then click OK. If you select both layers and scale them up, you will definitely see the difference. Here is the vector layer. And here is the raster one. Now let's move to the last step. Step 3. Vectorize multicolor logo or shape. In this step, I want to convert any colorful raster logo to a full vector. Here we have approximately 8 colors, and we should isolate each color and convert it to a vector. We should repeat what we did in step 2 for each color. And this will take you so much time. And to save your time, I just made an action that will do the job for you. You can download it for free from the description below. Now let's import our action from the Actions panel. Just click on this little icon and choose Load Actions. Select your action, then click Load. Open the action to see what's inside. First part here is to vectorize a single color logo or shape. The second part is for vectorizing any multicolor logo or shape. And finally, this part is for exporting the final result. Just select your layer, then go to the multicolor section and choose the prepare and resize action. Then click run. Your image size will increase and a color limit window will appear. Increase the colors number until you have the same colors in your main logo. Please keep this number as low as possible. Then click OK. Select the second action in the multicolor section. Then click Run. A color range menu will pop up. Just use the eyedropper tool to select any color and press Enter. As you can see here, the picked color will be removed from your image like that. Keep selecting colors and pressing Enter until you have an empty document. Once your document is empty, close that color range menu. Collapse your action and delete that empty raster layer. Unhide all layers. And this is your final full vector logo. Select the path selection tool to see our final result. Each color is isolated in a single shape layer. Let's export this final result. First, delete the before layer with a delete key. Then go to File, Export, Quick Export as PNG to save it as a PNG file. Or choose Export As to save it as an SVG, which is a scalable vector file. Just select SVG from that drop-down menu, then click Export. Finally, let's export it as an EPS file that can be used with any vector software like Illustrator. Just from the Save As, choose EPS from that drop-down menu. Click Save, and make sure the Include Vector Data is checked. Make sure your settings are the same as mine, then click OK. You can now open it with Illustrator. Let's check it out. Here's what we got. You can edit it completely as you want and deal with it as a pure vector. Now let's get back to our tutorial. Using the same free action, you can vectorize any single color logos like this previous one. Just select your raster layer, then open the action panel and run the first action in the single color section. Then run the second action. Pick the logo color and make sure the invert is unchecked. Then press Enter. Here is the final vector layer. You can export it as PNG, SVG, or EPS as before. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.